The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
What's her secret to that amazing shine? How do you think she gets her hair to look so soft?
Marie Claire's readers have discovered a very surprising secret to fabulous hair. New Head & Shoulders, an anti-dandruff shampoo that's not only unbeatable against flakes, but also leaves your hair unbelievably soft and shiny. Be surprised. And like Marie Claire's readers, try new Head & Shoulders.
Hi, I'm here about the room.
Come on in.
Hey, hi, I'll show you around. Kathy,
hiya.
Trainee chef. Won't let anyone else cook.
Ugh, cheek flick. Football legend!
I'm afraid you're stuck with the box room. Balcony.
Carlsberg don't do flatmates, but if we did, they'd probably be the best flatmates in the world.
Caviar mousse. Quail's egg souffle. Call this food?
Neither do we. At Coleman's, we believe a mighty meal is always a meaty meal. And only by adding Coleman's can you make it rump-slappingly meaty-licious.
Roast beef! Ritz! Sausage sardine!
Coleman's, for meaty-licious meat.
In MFI's best sale, we're rolling over our best ever offer. You still save up to half price, plus an extra 30% off absolutely everything in store. This Toscana kitchen with an extra 30% off is under £1,100, including appliances, worktops, everything. This Helsinki bedroom at just £249 is fantastic value. And with an extra 30% off storage accessories too. Don't miss out. The place to buy really is MFI.
Expertly trained.
I keep off the grass.
Ruthlessly efficient.
She's coming. Get to a safe place.
The perfect assassin.
Good boys.
Charlize Theron.
You may want to duck.
Eon Flux.
Indigestion. Rennie works fast to help neutralize excess stomach acid. Rennie, fast effective relief from indigestion.
Paper-free online loans mean we can now deal with customers' applications and give them their money faster than everyone else. High-speed loans from Lloyds DSB. Switch to a bank that puts you first.
They drink, I dream of you and the flowers. For a
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
So, how long have you been in South Florida?
A while.
Before that?
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
Oh, look at this lot struggling to get a six-pack. And three, and four. Don't they know how easy it is? Look at mine.
It was an accident.
There it is.
They barely escaped.
Ah, the driver's broken. Don't push the button.
ones who got off that roller coaster are still going to die.
It's become a destination.
You reinvented it like them urban legends.
They can't avoid.
I never thought I could see my own death before it happened.
You're dead!
Final Destination 3.
Meet you at the end.
These are not just roses. These are long-lasting velvet petal Grand Prix roses. This is not just champagne. This is exclusive Special Reserve Oudinot Rosé Champagne. This is not just Valentine's Day. This is M&S Valentine's Day.
Should we go somewhere a little quieter?
Oh, no, standing there would be good.
New Foster's Super Chilled. Well, you wouldn't want a warm beer, would you?
May I have your attention, please?
I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up? Hi, my name is...
What?
My name is... My name is...
Every time you hear the sound of my voice,
I never meant to make you cry, but tonight I'm cleaning out my closet.
Biggest fan, it's a stand.
Eminem, Curtain Call, all the greatest hits, and three new songs. Lose yourself in the music. Out now.
It's only a car. A car is a car is a car. With nuts and bolts and leather and cogs and steel and wood and glass. Intelligent wipers and head-up displays. Alloy and oil. Sensors and sound. Digital mapping and satellite tracking. Twists and turns and smiles and miles. Infrared eyes and self-drying brakes and one little key. It's only a car.
It's time to say thank you so much
for the music.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for the music.
The unmissable event of the year.
Bye, my lover.
It's time to say thank you for the music. The Brits 2006, coming soon to ITV1.
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
Nice car, mate.
Take a look at the stunning new Astra. Go drive.
Egg research revealed some guinea pigs were worried they had overspent a little.
Jamie and I felt that we'd been spending a bit too much.
Champagne truffles, guilty as charged.
So we did a check-up with Egg to see how we were doing with our money.
That's right, yeah.
And then we got a new Egg card.
We did.
It's got 0% on balance transfers.
Mm-hmm. And it's got 0% on new purchases.
Well, it was fabulous.
Oh, it was.
It really was. It felt like the lights had been turned on again.
Like this.
And now we can see where we are.
Financially.
Let's sort money out. Apply at egg.com.
Sexy.
It's simple, really. Everyone has the chance of winning a car. If you have one of these. Oh.
Win a Vauxhall Astra SRI with a Cars and Cash scratch card.
Got one in blue.
Mum will tell you, her baby could turn anything up to 12 times an hour while she sleeps. Every time she turns, her blankets and clothes rub against her. So they need to be cared for properly. Comfort Pure is the number one selling fabric softener for babies. Aww. It leaves their clothes delicately soft, helping everyone get, sorry, a cozy sleep.
Comfort Pure, our most delicate softeners for you and your baby.
Hurry down to your local Vauxhall retailer, where the Astra SXI is now available with no deposit, 0% finance and free insurance.
At 10:30, cured of a brain tumour, this 15-year-old's health is now in danger from a terrible blunder. Join me in 20 minutes.
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, what you need?
The guest of Mr. Barone's.
It's the whole Aces in here, bruh.
See you later.
Our premiere continues after the news.
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
Coming soon to ITV1.
Oh, a lamp! Excellent!
Hey, stop it! That tickles! Thanks, Aladdin! That lamp was cramping my style. Have 3 wishes on me.
Oh, cool! Then I wish to be as smart as a fox, as big as a bull, and fly like an eagle!
Then you need a Red Bull, Aladdin. It's stimulation for body and mind.
Wow! Red Bull gives you wings! You're a genius! I'm out of here!
Who's gonna rub me down? No!
Come here!
Thank you.
60 species from 30 countries. Young's bring the best fish from all over the world to your table. Via Grimsby. Young's, make fish the dish of the day.
Norwich Union Direct?
Yeah, it's a hatchback and I want you to quote me happy. Go on, make me happy.
Take this up to our Michael, would you?
All right, love.
Yes! Yes! I love you! Oh. Fantastic! That's brilliant, thank you.
All right, Mum.
Just like his granddad.
You could save up to £170 on your car insurance when you call 0800 828 838 or buy online and let us quote you happy.
Hello. If you're on pay as you go with Three, you now get paid for answering your calls and receiving texts. You pick up, we pay up. Three, welcome to our network.
Hey! What do you think?
Try this one.
No, it's dirty, love.
Oh, thanks, love. Aww. See you later.
Detergent and fabric conditioner in one easy-to-use liquid tab. New bowl 2-in-1. Winter can make your hair dry, but you can rescue it. Pantene Winter Rescue Shampoo and Conditioner. Our Provitamin formula replenishes moisture to help combat the signs of winter damage. The Winter Rescue Collection. Damaged in winter, rescued by Pantene. Pantene is supported by the Institute of Trichologists, the UK's hair expert since 1902.
Now from Rimmel London, new volume Extend Mascara. Two steps to full-on sexy lashes. Step 1, 50% more length and curve. Step 2, 15 times more body. The more you put on, the sexier you are. New volume Extend Mascara from Rimmel London.
Chrysler Crossfire range from 24,995 now with free smart knife.
My God, it's working.
Science has no conscience outside of those who control it.
Science needs to be in the public domain. You can't own that kind of information.
You do own it.
Go to hell.
Its purpose is to stop them before we reach darkness. Stop it! 11th Hour, starring Patrick Stewart, Thursday at 9 on ITV1.
Calling all viewers. Saturday night on ITV1 begins with Harry Hill's TV burp at 5:30. At 6, it's Kat and the kids.
Tonight, Kat, I'm going to be...
The Race for Glory continues at 7 with Dancing on Ice. And at 8, it's a very special Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Lawrence and Jackie Llewellyn Bowen.
Lawrence is really brainy.
You are the brains and the beauty.
And which couple will be skating off into the sunset at 9:10? That's Saturday night on ITV1.
Risky business, but will they get their man? Too Fast, Too Furious continues after the ITV news.
The dangerous delay. Why was Abu Hamza left free for so long? Were there links between him and the London bombers? Tonight, the preacher of hate and the unanswered questions. Allegations of complacency and calls for inquiries this evening after it's emerged the security services tolerated his support for terrorism despite warnings from abroad. Also tonight, the appalling medical blunder that meant this teenage cancer patient was given a radiation overdose 17 times. Around the world in 80 hours, Steve Fossett's latest attempt to fly into the record books. And at the double, the Premiership's as good as over. Now Chelsea close in on the FA Cup.
Political history is made as the Isle of Man gives 16-year-olds the vote. That story and more in 20 minutes.
Good evening. A picture of complacency, of allowing Abu Hamza to carry on his evil preaching, became worryingly clear tonight. Documents were revealed to ITV News today which show the concerns of our security services almost 10 years ago. Alarm bells were ringing in France and in America too. Reports today linked Hamza with the London suicide bombers. So if he had been stopped sooner, could lives have been saved? Our crime correspondent Dan Rivers reports.
The big unanswered question tonight is whether Abu Hamza preached his sermons of violence and martyrdom to the very same men who later carried out the first suicide bombings in Britain on July the 7th. Were those terrorists here among the fanatical followers at Finsbury Park Mosque? And crucially, if Hamza had been charged earlier, would Mohammed Sadiq Khan's gang have been radicalized to the point of detonating their four rucksack bombs in the capital, killing 52 people and injuring 700?
Anything will happen, father, do it! If it's killing, do it!
Press reports suggest three of the July 7th terrorists did attend Hamza's zealous preachings. The police tonight are denying they have evidence for that yet, but admit they wouldn't be surprised if it was found soon. It makes questions about why Hamza wasn't charged earlier all the more prescient.
It's a good question. Bear in mind, the government is forever saying they're trying to put in place laws that allow them to prevent terrorism. Early action on Mr. Hamza might have helped prevent some people becoming involved in terrorism.
Today, Abu Hamza's solicitor showed me documents proving he'd met MI5 as far back as October 1997. She claims there was a tacit agreement that he would not be charged. Even when police seized his videos in 1999, they returned them, saying they weren't illegal.
Why wasn't he prosecuted then? Why wait some 10 years later to prosecute him?
The only conclusion seems to be that either they missed the things that they thought were insightful, or, as you're suggesting, there was some change in policy.
There is a change in policy.
One explanation is that before September the 11th, the authorities here were operating the so-called Londonistan policy, allowing radical extremists to live in Britain, providing they didn't carry out attacks here. But after 9/11, attitudes hardened. But it was still years before Hamza was charged. He began preaching at Finsbury Park Mosque in 1997. That year, MI5 made their first contact with him, warning he was walking a tightrope with his sermons, but he remained free. MI5 continued the meetings, giving him code names, including Next Week, 9/10 and Damsonbury. Hamza told them he considered the UK a place to relax and breathe, implying he wasn't planning any attacks. But a year later, he met the shoe bomber Richard Reid at the mosque. The documents reveal that by now he'd had six formal interviews with MI5. In 2002, the press claimed two of the July 7th bombers also visited. Finally, in 2003, the police raided the mosque, forcing Hamza to preach his sermons in the street, where it's claimed Jermaine Lindsay, the third London bomber, attended. Abu Hamza was arrested 5 months later. The CPS and police say Abu Hamza was prosecuted as soon as there was sufficient evidence. But many are asking if that's really true, or if July the 7th could have been prevented by earlier action. Dan Rivers, ITV News.
Well, Dan's outside Finsbury Park Mosque in North London now. So, Dan, take us through these unanswered questions. Why did it take so long?
Well, that is the absolute nub to this, Mark, I think. Why wasn't action taken in 1999? The police seized many of the same videos that they relied on in court this week back in 1999, 570 in all. They held on to them for 10 months. There was plenty of time to examine that evidence. Much of it was there. The tapes themselves didn't change, but action was only taken after September the 11th and after the Americans requested Abu Hamza's extradition. The CPS said they acted once they had sufficient evidence, but they haven't answered the question why, when the evidence was there in 1999, did they not do something?
Dan Rivers, thank you. At 15 and with a brain tumour, Lisa Norris trusted her doctors to make her better. Now her life is in danger, not from the tumour, but from the treatment she was given. She was subjected to overdoses of radiation on 17 occasions. As Martin Geisler reports, Lisa can only wait and hope its effects won't be fatal.
I'm not even listening.
What, it's so heavy?
Really, I'm in it for this.
Lisa Norris has had a lot to get used to lately. Her new wig, while an inconvenience, is the least of her worries. Today, the 15-year-old was brave enough to show her scars to the camera. Damage done not by her illness, but by a dreadful error from the medical staff who treated her. 5 months ago, Lisa was told she had a brain tumour. She had to endure chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Last week, she was still celebrating being given the all-clear when doctors told her they'd administered a massive radiation overdose on every one of her 17 visits. They don't know what damage that's done.
We don't know what's in the future, because I could be, well, it says I could be brain damaged, I could be paralysed. Later down in the future, like 10 to 15 years, I could not be here. It's just time will tell if anything's going to happen.
So far, this ordeal has caused Lisa's hair to fall out and her skin to blister. Today, the Royal College of Radiologists confirmed it could conceivably go on to damage her nervous system and brain and paralyse her. Today, this from the man in charge of the unit which administered the radiation overdose.
We are very sorry that this mistake has happened. Immediately upon discovering the overdose, we launched an internal investigation. This investigation established that no equipment failure was involved, but that the overdose was the result of human error.
In fact, it's thought three physicists gave Lisa too much radiotherapy and two administrators failed to notice that mistake. While the hospital says it means no other patients need fear, that does nothing to console this family.
Well, I'm really angry with them and shouldn't they get away with it. By right, they should be put out their job, not allowed back in the NHS. Ever, because it could happen to somebody else.
Not surprisingly, the Norris family are understood to be discussing this affair with their lawyers. They have a more pressing appointment, though, in 3 weeks' time. That's when Lisa is due back in hospital to undergo an MRI scan. Perhaps her first chance of a clearer prognosis. Martin Geisler, ITV News, Glasgow.
Right, still to come on the programme. Serenity on the roof of the world shattered in Nepal. Eyewitness video of the mayhem of rebellion that's brought chaos to the country's elections. But first, America let it be known today who it thinks is behind the continuing wave of Muslim anger over the cartoons of the Prophet Muhammad. Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice pointed the finger at Iran and Syria. And President Bush called on the governments of countries where it was happening to put a stop to it. From Washington, Robert Moore.
Good morning. Enraged, more deadly protests in the Muslim
world. For days, America has responded with caution to the scenes of violence sweeping some parts of the Muslim world, urging calm while saying freedom of expression comes with the responsibility to respect Muslim sentiment. But now the political temperature is rising. The U.S. government today accused two old enemies of inciting the riots and of deliberately stirring up trouble for their own ends.
That Iran and Syria have gone out of their way to inflame sentiments and to use this to their own purposes, and the world ought to call them on it.
Over at the White House, there is similar concern that the row over the cartoons is powerful ammunition for Islamic radicals who are seeking to inflame tensions.
The reaction to the cartoons.
It prompted the president today to intervene directly for the first time during a meeting with the Jordanian leader, King Abdullah.
I call upon the governments around the world to stop the violence, to be respectful.
The stakes are high for the United States. The victory of Hamas in the Palestinian elections is already seen as a blow to America's ambition of fostering moderation in the Middle East. Now extremists can use the cartoons as another recruiting tool.
Only one American newspaper, the Philadelphia Inquirer, has actually published the cartoons over here. And the White House is on the one hand left pleading for tolerance, and on the other, warning Iran and Syria not to take further advantage of the turmoil that is now sweeping across the Muslim world. Robert Moore, ITV News, Washington.
Let's get some more of tonight's news now. Police searching for a missing baby in Birmingham say they found a body. 6-month-old Troy Simpson was reported missing from his home in Smethwick yesterday. The body, which was found this evening in a drain near his home, has not yet been identified. 4 people have been arrested. And the rock star Pete Doherty, ex-boyfriend of Kate Moss, has been sentenced to 12 months community service for possessing drugs The baby shambles singer risks jail, though if he breaks his drug rehabilitation order. High in the Himalayas, the turnout has been very low in Nepal's elections today. The country is in the grip of a Maoist rebellion, making the polls in a nation sandwiched between the emerging powers of China and India more sensitive than ever. Since the Mountain Kingdom's last elections in 1997, Parliament and the monarchy have wrestled for power. The royal family was almost wiped out in an incredible drunken row. The heir to the throne killed his parents, his sister, his brother, and then himself. The king's brother, Gyandra, succeeded and imposed absolute rule. Many Nepalese haven't voted today, terrified of reprisals by Maoist rebels. From Nepal, our Asia correspondent, John Irvine, reports.
On this election day, Kathmandu has been a city of empty streets and empty polling stations. The authorities here didn't like us filming what voting there was, for as elections go, this one is embarrassing.
The government has given the security forces here orders to shoot to kill anybody interfering with this election. But interference isn't the big problem. The problem is a lack of interest.
Are you going to vote today?
No, absolutely not.
Why not?
Because this election is not proper.
Are you going to vote today?
No. I'm not interested.
Nepal is widely regarded as an inspirational nation whose inhabitants live not just on the roof of the world, but somehow on a higher plane than the rest of us. And yet right now, this land of supposed enlightenment is in trouble.
Well, the political situation is deteriorating day by day. It seems all the people involved in the political game are egocentric.
This week, attacks by Maoist rebels have claimed nearly 20 lives. To scupper the election, the rebels also called a general strike, and while some in the city centre are ignoring it, the further you go into the suburbs, the more the strike is biting. Soon, ours was the only car on the road. The edge of town has become a frontier. Here's where King Gyanendra's realm effectively ends. The hinterland is controlled by the Maoists. Nepalese troops travel this road at their peril. This is the immediate aftermath of a rebel ambush on that same road. They're celebrating after attacking a lorry and killing two soldiers. These are rare pictures of the world's last Maoists. For a decade, they've been fighting to topple the monarchy. The rebels have seized control of most of the countryside. In Nepal, it's not democracy, but communism that's on the march. In Kathmandu, there is a huge security force presence, but it's not just the Maoist threat that's keeping people away from the polls. All the main political parties have boycotted this election because it's seen as a ploy by the king to legitimize his rule. He seized absolute power a year ago.
The people of Nepal have become pawns in a power struggle between the king and the communists. And the fact that that struggle has reached absolute stalemate is underlined by the irrelevance of this election. John Irvine, ITV News, Kathmandu.
Time for a quick look at the markets. The FTSE 100 finished the day at 5,725 points, down 21. The Dow Jones has jumped 108 points to 10,858, and the pound is trading at €1.45, down almost a fifth of a cent. Now, sport. Felicity.
Thank you, Mark. And Chelsea have breezed into the last 16 of the FA Cup with a 4-1 win over Everton in their fourth round replay. The Premiership champions were always in control at Stamford Bridge. Iron Robin put them ahead early on before a Frank Lampard penalty. And Hernan Crespo's goal made it 3-0 by half-time. Mikel Arteta converted a penalty to bring Everton briefly back into the game. But John Terry sealed a 4-1 victory. Chelsea now meet League One leaders Colchester in the next round. Elsewhere, Middlesbrough beat Coventry in the only other fourth round tie to be settled. Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank's goal sealed a trip to Preston in the next round. So no shocks in the Cup, but there was one in the Premiership. Charlton beating third place Liverpool with goals from Darren Bent and Luke Young. And in the Scottish Premier League, Aberdeen beat Rangers and Roy Keane scored in Celtic's win over Falkirk. Among the other results, Hibs thrash Livingston 7-0. Hearts owner Vladimir Romanov has agreed to meet the club's captain over allegations that he's picking the team ahead of coach Graham Rix. The players are angry at claims that the Lithuanian personally made six changes to the team ahead of their 1-1 draw at Dundee United last night. Captain Stephen Presley says the meeting is crucial.
As a group of players, we had a discussion and we came to a unanimous decision that we would be seeking talks with Mr. Romanov in order to try and resolve the situation. Okay, that's all I've got to say. No, that's sorry, thanks, but that's all.
Just a couple, Stephen.
Thank you.
He said he was sorry and I forgave him. That's how England defender Rio Ferdinand says he and Sven-Göran Eriksson resolved things after the England coach described him as lazy. Ferdinand also says that this England squad is the best he's ever played in. He spoke exclusively to Geraint Vincent.
The man once described as the Rolls-Royce of defenders has had some ups and downs this season, with being called lazy by the England coach one of the deepest downs. But it seems Rio Ferdinand has taken all that in his stride.
I took it with a pinch of salt, to be honest, yeah. The whole situation arose, as people now know, that through the papers on a Sunday. I spoke to the manager that day, and obviously what we said between us will stay between us. But I was very comfortable when I put the phone down, definitely.
He was apologetic, presumably?
Yeah.
Ferdinand was in London last night with some Manchester United colleagues playing futsal, a Brazilian version of the game designed to encourage skillful play, something the centre-back will be keen to hone in the run-up to the World Cup, which he thinks England have a great chance of winning.
The ability in this squad is more than I've ever been involved in, to be honest with you. That's no disrespect to the other groups of players that I've been alongside. As I said, on paper, it all bodes well for us, but as I said, we've got to go out there and produce before we can start singing.
Such is the competition in England's central defence, Ferdinand's place in that starting lineup is by no means assured. Neither, of course, is that of the troubled Sol Campbell.
I don't really want to talk about Sol Campbell, to be honest. I think he's got enough to worry about himself rather than me egging in and saying a few bits and pieces. I think a lot of people have had enough to say about the situation already, and he's a friend of mine, and I don't think it's right for me to really be speaking to him about him on TV.
After a shaky start, Ferdinand's form this season is heading upwards, and he'll spend the next 5 months trying to make himself as indispensable to the England team as the man on his right. Geraint Vincent, ITV News.
Scotland have made one change to the team which beat the Six Nations favourites, France, at the weekend. Scott Lawson replaces Dougie Hall as hooker for the match against Wales on Sunday. Coach Frank Haddon is brimming with confidence, but still won't predict a second straight victory.
What happens if you train well is it gives you confidence that you're going to play well. And we know we're going to be very competitive this weekend. But who can tell what the outcome will be? Because Wales have got a fantastic side. They've done great things over the last season. They were an inspiration to us by winning the Six Nations last year. And they're on their home patch with a huge support behind them. It's going to be extremely tough this weekend.
Well, defending champions Wales are unchanged for that match against the Scots in Cardiff. They're sticking with the same 15 which lost to England at Twickenham. And for the very last time, that is it from me, Mark.
Felicity, we'll miss you. Coming up at the nerve centre of the latest round-the-world record attempt, the tension tonight. That plus tomorrow morning's newspapers. First, let's rejoin our ITV News colleagues around the UK.
Hello, good evening. Political history has been made in the Isle of Man. It's to be the first place in Europe to give 16 and 17-year-olds the right to vote. The Manx general election will be held later this year, with the thousands of new young voters expected to have a significant impact on the results.
This group of 16 and 17-year-old students from Ballacameen High School are old enough to join the armed forces and to get married, but they can't vote in general elections. Now that's all set to change as the Isle of Man leads the way in giving younger people the right to vote.
I would, yes. I think it's a good idea because before you could get married and make a commitment for life, and now you can sign a piece of paper.
I'm not sure actually, because I think it's a good idea, but we need to be more educated in politics and that side of things.
The majority of members of the House of Keys voted in favour of a politically historical move. Only four were against it, on the grounds that some 16-year-olds would not be mature enough to handle a responsibility. Leading the reform, Government Minister Steve Roden, a former education minister, said this was an opportunity for the Isle of Man to do pioneering work.
As far as I'm aware, we are the first parliament in Europe, certainly in the democratic world, to give 16 and 17-year-olds the right to vote. So it's a very historic occasion.
If the legislation is carried through in time, up to 2,000 extra votes could be cast at this year's Manx general election in November. The Isle of Man was the first country in the world to give women the vote, and it now looks as though that right will be extended to 16 and 17-year-olds. Whether they vote at this year's general election remains to be seen.
Joanne Green there. An investigation's underway after an 18-year-old man was killed in a crash in the Lake District. The teenager was heading towards Kendal on the A591 when his car was in collision with two other vehicles. The road isn't notorious for accidents, and police are trying to discover exactly what happened.
The wreckage of a crash which tonight leaves one family grieving. Here on the A591 at 9:10 this morning, this Peugeot 106 collided with two other vehicles. The driver of that car, an 18-year-old man, died at the scene.
What appears to have happened is that there's a silver Peugeot 106 that was travelling from Windermere towards Kendal has lost control. It's hit the minibus and then it's hit a Land Rover Freelander.
This fatal accident is just the latest in a series of collisions in Cumbria which have claimed lives. This particular stretch of road isn't known for being especially dangerous. Focus is now turning to what exactly happened.
We're very interested in anybody that's actually seen the accident, particularly the manner of driving of the silver Peugeot. The focus of the investigation at this moment in time is on how that vehicle was being driven.
The driver of the Land Rover is recovering in hospital tonight. Passengers on the minibus, believed to be an RAF one, escaped unharmed.
Meanwhile, police have named the woman who died in a car crash on the A69 at Low Row near Brampton yesterday. It was 53-year-old Margaret Bonner from Greenhead near Brampton. She died after her car was in collision with a lorry. The road was closed because of an accident, and it became an accident black spot, with this the third fatality in just 2 months. There are now calls for the road to be made into a dual carriageway. After 30 years of campaigning, villagers in Temple Sowerby in North Cumbria have been told they'll get their bypass. Serious road accidents near the village have claimed three lives in recent years. Work on the £40 million dual carriageway is expected to begin next month and will take 2 years to complete. Now, the Isle of Man Health Minister Steve Roden has tonight been challenged amid claims that budget cuts will have a huge impact on frontline services. Douglas MHK Bill Henderson has confronted the minister over an email claiming to be from a member of staff. It states that the gynaecology ward will be closed, making emergency services for women extremely difficult. It also suggests that beds will close in intensive care and the heart care as well. So far, no one from the health services has been available for comment. Now it's time to take a look at the weather with Debbie.
Border weather with BMIBaby.com.
Hello again, it's going to be a cold and frosty night. Let's get straight on to the details. Remaining dry right the way throughout tonight. Temperatures underneath the clearing skies getting down to -2 or -3 Celsius. The wind's light and from the north. Tomorrow's sun times rising in the morning at 7:47, setting tomorrow afternoon at 5:06. Tomorrow a cold and frosty start, but a bright one. It should remain bright right the way throughout tomorrow. Again, dry temperatures on the disappointing side, but not surprising for this time in the month. Up to around 4 or 5 Celsius. The winds from the northwest, but not quite as strong as this afternoon. Have a good night.
Border weather with BMIBaby.com, the airline with tiny fares.
Debbie, thanks very much. Now it's time to go back to Mark Austin in London with the rest of the ITV news. Good night.
Hello again. Let's get a recap now of our main stories. Documents seen by ITV News show British security services had concerns about the radical cleric Abu Hamza for almost 10 years. It also emerged that he had been questioned by police dozens of times since, as early as 1997. The health of a 15-year-old girl is threatened tonight after she was subjected to overdoses of radiation, not once, but on 17 occasions. Lisa Norris was being treated for a brain tumour at a hospital in Glasgow. And on this programme, the England defender Rio Ferdinand says he's forgiven Sven-Göran Eriksson for describing him as lazy after the England coach said he was sorry. Now he's at it again. The adventurous Steve Fossett is roughly, what, 10.5 hours into his latest round-the-world record attempt. He's trying to fly further than anyone else, non-stop. Takeoff was in Florida. Mission control is in West Sussex. From there, Romilly Weeks reports on the flight that'll take Fossett around the world in 80 hours.
For the next 3.5 days, this tiny cockpit will be home for Steve Fossett, setting off on his bid to fly further than any aircraft in history. Today, his first and most dangerous challenge, the takeoff, went smoothly. His single-engine aircraft carrying 6 times its weight in fuel, taking to the skies like a bird.
You crossed 34 north 10 minutes ago.
On the ground, his support team is in constant contact, advising him of his optimum speed and most wind-friendly route, as he tries to make it 1.25 times round the world with at the most just snatched minutes of sleep.
He's fine. We've been in contact with him. We had a little glitch on the position reporting equipment on board the aircraft, but that's now fixed. And he's just got sort of getting settled into the flight and getting himself prepared for the next 70-odd hours.
Here in Mission Control, they're tracking Steve's flight every second of the day and night. This chart over here shows his current position midway over the Atlantic, heading for the Canaries down here. If the winds stay in his favour, he should reach Egypt by morning. He will then head for India, Japan and on to the US. If all goes to plan, he'll land in Kent on Saturday afternoon, a record breaker. Romilly Weeks, ITV News in Sussex.
Good luck to him. Time for a quick look at tomorrow's front pages. The Times has the ongoing fallout from the Abu Hamza trial. It says America will use phone tap evidence to try to jail the convicted cleric for life, evidence that was deemed inadmissible by British courts. The Daily Mail shows Lisa Norris, who was given massive overdoses of radiation by the doctors treating her. It also reports that babies are to get 25 vaccinations in a year, sparking fears of immunisation overload. The Guardian says we're facing an obesity crisis and that warning labels will be put on so-called fat foods, telling us how many calories are in certain products. And the FT says that the British Airports Authority is preparing its defences against a potential takeover bid by a Spanish construction group. There we are. Those are tomorrow's headlines and that's tonight's news. Now from me, from Felicity and from all of us here, good night and thank you for watching.
ITV National Weather, sponsored by Powergen.
Hello, good evening. Well, tonight we're certainly paying the price for today's lovely sunshine. These clear skies translate into dipping temperatures, a widespread frost. And of course, there have been some showers around today. In fact, they're confined still to the northeast. Those showers mean slippery surfaces tonight. Obviously, extra care is needed. Windy with it as well, dividing the country into a west-east split for tomorrow. Starting with the west, bright, breezy start to the day. Some good amounts of sunshine on offer. In direct contrast for the eastern side, we've a fair few showers spilling down these parts. And these are wintry in nature, even as far south as East Anglia there. As you'd expect, temperatures aren't too great at all. In fact, a cold day held at, roughly speaking, 5 to 7. The wind making it feel all the colder. Good night.
Positive energy from Powergen.
We're back with Too Fast, Too Furious next tonight, and after that, Jodie Marsh with her Orange Playlist.
Great.
Grass is one of the main forages on most farms. Dry grass silage poses a very different challenge to that of wet grass silage, which is why Biotal has two grass silage inoculants to cover all weather conditions. Biotal's enzyme system opens up the grass fiber to increase availability, giving improved performance and profitability. For wet or dry conditions, make the right choice. Make it Biotal.
You know, there is such a thing as being a little bit pregnant. First Response is sensitive enough to detect the pregnancy hormone at the first stages of pregnancy, as early as 4 days before your period is due. First Response. No other test can be used earlier.
Pearl Drop's new Hollywood smile whitens teeth brilliantly. Feel the shine. See the whiteness in 3 weeks. And because you won't believe the difference, you get a free whiteness guide to prove it. Hollywood smile. For whiteness you can measure or your money back.
Orange. But I like orange.
Outside, it's dull, dull, dull. Inside, it's white, white, white. Our great price on 7.5 litres of Dulux Pure Brilliant White will cheer you up.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
New V8 is a mouth-watering blend of 7 fruit juices and carrot juice. The tasty way to get real vegetable goodness.
Visit Dunmow Park and enjoy fabulous big brand shopping. There's something for everyone with ladies' fashions, menswear and children's wear. Bed linen, china, glass, giftware and toys. There's an amazing choice of famous name upholstery, beds, bedroom and dining furniture. Plus superb restaurants, free parking and late night shopping. Dunmow Park, open 7 days a week.
Nice if good things never ended. Well, on Orange Pay As You Go, every month you can get up to 50% of your top-ups back to use the next month. So you've always got something to look forward to.
Jodie Marsh reveals, oh, when it comes to her music taste, it's after more from our movie, Too Fast, Too Furious.
The Razer V3X with 3G. Getting you home in time for the ITV movie.
Hello, Moto.
Nice shirt, Bilkins.
It's my day off.
Yeah. Well, anyhow, this is the deal. Last night, Barone threatened a cop and he given us a window.
Razer V3X sponsors ITV movies.
Hello, Moto.
Nightmare, I don't have enough to get something to eat.
Yes, you do.
But wait, it's still the same amount I had before.
That's right. You don't need much to get a sub of the day every day. For just $1.99, you can get a delicious sub of the day made fresh right in front of you at Subway. Subway. Eat fresh.
It's class time!
Observe!
Noddy.
Nobbies.
Noddy. Nobbies.
Thick.
Be the arse nodder.
Nibble nubby sick Chris!
Jada. Wouldn't it be nice if work Jada. Didn't feel like work? Jada, Jada, and you could make Monday morning feel like Friday night? Jada. Maybe you could. Why not overdress for work? It might make your day.
It's a funny little melody, but it's so soothing and appealing to me.
There's a million ways to make your day. Mars Delight's just one of them.
You raise me up.
Capital Gold, the very best of love legends.
Love is all around me.
40 of the greatest love songs of all time. Feel the moment with Capital Gold, the very best of love legends, the perfect Valentine's gift.
Forget those February blues. Try reds, yellows, purples. Our great price on 2.5 litres of Dulux coloured emulsion will cheer you up.
Have you heard about Tiscali Unlimited Broadband?
What about it?
You get free modem, free connection. And all for only $14.99 a month.
$14.99? You're right in there, love.
Broadband at $14.99? I should say so.
For unlimited broadband for just $14.99, call Tiscali now on 0800 107 9000.
Why is Actimel such a great way to start the day?
Ah, I feel good!
An essential part of your natural defences are in your gut. This is where the good bacteria do an important job. Actimel with L-Cassi Immunitas can help top up the good bacteria, which make life harder for the bad bacteria.
So good! So good! I got it!
So start the day the right way. Actimel. Make life harder for bad bacteria.
This is what a Honda feels like.
You may think you're tough, but I eat men like you for breakfast.
The movie premiere, Intolerable Cruelty, next Wednesday at 9, ITV1.
You're with ITV1, and now it's Orange Playlist.
Life's better when it's set to music.
Find out next.
In case you're confused about who's offering cheaper energy, we've decided to keep our message simple. Are you listening? Scottish Power has been cheaper than Scottish Gas for combined gas and electricity for the average customer for not one, not two, but 3 years running, and we're still cheaper. So there you have it. 3 years of cheaper energy from the energy people, Scottish Power.
Yeah. We won't be a second.
Should we?
Nah, more than give you a car insurance quote in a couple of minutes. It's dead easy.
Lucky.
Nice car, Tom.
Yeah. Hey, look, I've got my quote.
That's lucky.
Andy says I could save even more if I buy online.
more than lucky.
Save more on car insurance when you buy online at morethan.com.
Research revealed some guinea pigs were worried they had overspent a little.
Jamie and I felt that we'd been spending a bit too much.
Champagne truffles, guilty as charged.
So we did a check-up with Egg to see how we were doing with our money.
That's right, yeah.
And then we got a new Egg card.
We did.
It's got 0% on balance transfers.
Mm-hmm. And it's got 0% on new purchases.
Well, it was fabulous.
Oh, it was.
It really was. It felt like the lights had been turned on again.
Like this.
And now we can see where we are.
Financially.
Let's sort money out. Apply at egg.com.
I never seem to really hit it off with women.
Well, you're not going to, looking like that. Image consultants, my friend really, really needs your help.
Let me do the talking.
Hi.
Hi.
Yes.
Nice shirt. I like it.
Right. Well, oh dear. Green is so not your colour.
Yellow pages. Whatever you want, just yell.
Heartburn. Rennie works fast to help neutralise excess stomach acid. Rennie, fast effective relief from heartburn.
Yeah, oops, I nearly dropped the phone. Anyway, oh Jenny, this cat food looks almost homemade. It's Felix. It's called As Good As It Looks. Well, it's completely different. Sort of meaty flakes, very posh looking. Unlike Felix himself. And judging by a certain gentleman's behaviour, it tastes pretty good too.
Felix As Good As It Looks. Seeing is believing.
Hello, as this mum will tell you, her baby could turn anything up to 12 times an hour while she sleeps. Every time she turns, her blankets and clothes rub against her. So they need to be cared for properly. Comfort Pure is the number one selling fabric softener for babies. Aww. It leaves their clothes delicately soft, helping everyone get, sorry, a cozy sleep.
Comfort Pure, our most delicate softness for you and your baby. Chrysler Crossfire range from $24,995 now with free smart knife.
Thought the sun.
Tell me what happened. Everything.
Scary.
Just got sexy.
With the Orange Playlist Tour, and your favourite future hit this week is...
We are scientists!
They rock.
Yeah, they do.
Better than any science lesson.